Hey guys, my name is Matt Cooper. I'm a junior here at NC State, and I help serve with the evangelism team here at NC State as well. And we were hoping to get you guys to set up your 3 to 5 minute testimony on Facebook, and I'm gonna give you a little tutorial on how to do that with some tips. First thing that you really want to do is really pray and ask God for just wisdom and guidance as you're preparing your testimony and what He would have you say in it. Second thing you're going to want to do is come up with a theme, whether that's joy or purpose or something that was lacking in your life before you knew Christ and now you found through Christ. We're going to set this up into three main points. Your life before you knew Christ, how you came to know Christ, and then how your life is now different after receiving Christ. And we do want a theme that's constant throughout, because that really helps with continuity and helps people to just really follow what you're talking about. So if I say before I knew Christ that I was really lacking joy in my life, then I want to make sure that I talk about how I found joy in Christ, not joy before and then purpose after. It just wouldn't really match up. So that's something that you really want to keep in mind. Everybody has a point before they knew Christ where they just were not complete. They didn't know the Lord. And so we really want to hit in on that. Even if you came to Christ at a very early age, there was still a time before you knew Christ. When you're talking about how you received Christ, at this point in the video, we really want to make sure that we're clearly explaining the gospel. So instead of saying, for example, I went to Young Life Camp and I heard the gospel for the first time, you might instead say, I went to Young Life Camp and I heard that Jesus Christ died on the cross for my sins, and that because of that He offered me a free gift of a relationship with Him, and all I had to do is receive it. So that way nobody hears your testimony and doesn't clearly hear the gospel explained to them. After you receive Christ, you really want to talk about not just, hey, I found joy or I found purpose, but you really want to explain specific ways that that's played out in your life. Like, I really found a purpose in my life, and it has played out in me really understanding what I want to do as a career, and how I really fit into, you know, how I can glorify God with my life. And so just getting into something specific like that, something that people can really relate to. That's one of the awesome things about a testimony, is that it's relational. Yeah, we really want to be thinking about being in the shoes of a non-believer. How can we relate to them? We don't want to throw out churchy words like atoned or salvation or just things like that that can really be very easily misunderstood. And we also want to be careful not to hit on or bash any denominations or organizations or anything like that, because that's really taking away from the purpose. Alright guys, so now that we've talked a little bit about how to actually prepare your testimony, we're going to look at some of the tech side of things as far as actually posting it up. So if you have a PC, what we're going to do is we're going to start by pulling up Windows Live Movie Maker, which all PC computers should have that. And you're going to look over here and click webcam video, and it'll load you up like it just did me. Before you hit the record button, you're going to want to make sure that you have a couple things straight. First of all, you want to make sure that you look real fly, because you don't want to look greasy and nasty when you're recording this video, for your sake and for their sake. So a good starting place would be to make sure that you've taken a shower before you record your testimony. You also want to make sure that you don't have it down here staring at your chest or up like this, because that just doesn't look good. So get it nice and centered on you, and now you're ready to record. So we're gonna come over here and press the record button. And at this point, you're just gonna share your testimony. Hopefully you've practiced it a couple times so it sounds pretty smooth, and you've got it to where it's within 3 to 5 minutes so you can keep people's attention span. When you're finished recording your testimony, which is gonna be a lot longer than this, but you're going to want to come over here and press the stop button, like so, and it's going to bring up a place where you can save it. You're going to want to choose wherever you want and name it whatever you want, but for us, we're going to go into Alan and my videos, and we're going to save it just as the default Capture One, and we're going to hit save. You can go back and play this thing over again and make sure that it looks the way that you want it to look, and there's not any editing issues or whatever, and you can redo it if it doesn't look the way that you want it to. So there's like a little preview thing. Now going back to Facebook, you're going to want to go to your profile and you're going to click photo, which is slightly misleading, but that's what you're clicking, even though you want video. And you're going to hit upload photo slash video and you're going to hit choose file. Now you're going to want to remember where you put it. So I'm going to Allen and then my videos right here and see capture one. So I'm going to hit open and you're going to see it in there by the choose file button. But you don't want to just hit post. You're going to want to come up here in the text and write a little something like, hey, this is how God changed me. If you want to see more, go to howgodchangedme.com, which is a website that we've worked on real hard with the evangelism team and have put just a lot of work in, and so we want to make sure that we really direct people towards this site. There's some really good video testimonies on this website, so make sure you do that. And you're going to come down here to this little button with the person's head and the plus sign, which is how you tag people, if you didn't know that. And you're going to want to tag any non-believers that you might want in this video, because if you tag them in it, they're likely going to actually take the time to watch the video. Then you're going to want to hit the post button and it's going to be up on Facebook, which I know is a little scary, but hopefully some non-believers are going to be able to see this and how God has worked in your life, and it'll be up on their news feeds and on your wall, and especially those people that you tagged in it. And so this is just a really cool step of faith that we'd love to see you guys take, and be prepared to really have some of those conversations with folks if maybe they come and ask you about it, or even if you want to initiate the conversation, be like, hey, what did you think of that video that I put up? So we're really excited to see what God does here, and praying for you guys.